In 1985, musical history was being made in Memphis. There in the Sun Studios, where Elvis had recorded his first records, four of the founding fathers of rock and roll had gathered for a reunion album, The Class of 55. Johnny Cash was joined by Roy Orbison, Jerry Lee Lewis, and Rick Nelson's idol, Carl Perkins. When Rick got word of the reunion, he flew to Memphis. Carl Perkins recalls the moment when the man and his mentor came face to face.
Well, I first met Rick in September, which will be 2 years coming up this September, So I'm walking across the studio. Such a handsome dude, and so healthy looking, still so young looking, just, and had that great little crooked smile that he had. He put his hand out, and I met him about middle ways of the floor. I saw him coming that way, and so we just met and shook hands, and but then it just went right on into a gentleman bear hug, you know. I said, "Golly, Bill." He said, "Took a long time, didn't it?" Never forget him saying that. He said it sure took. He said it sure took a long time. I said, "Just a little too long, Rick, man. How are you doing?" You know. And then we kind of paired off a little bit that afternoon. He'd slide over, and we sat around together. We talked about working some together next year. I said, "Man, I sure would love to open some shows for you." He said, "Oh, gosh, you serious?" I said, "I sure am, man." He said, "But it'd have to be the other way around."
1985 was a time for reunions. Rick was on the road with his old friends, the Jordanaires, playing concerts with his Imperial record buddy, Fats Domino. As a companion piece to that concert series, he joined the Jordanaires and Jimmy Haskell in the studios to re-record his biggest hits. Gordon Stoker recalls,
It was just an eerie feeling. It's just a very, very strange thing. It just brought back a lot of memories to do all those things, you know, that you'd done so many years before that.
The album would indeed bring Rick full circle back to "I'm Walkin', Travelin' Man" and all the other songs that made him one of the most enduring legends in the history of rock and roll. But it would also mark the fourth time he recorded the Johnny and Dorsey Burnett rockabilly classic. Thurley Burnett says that Johnny and Dorsey had no idea that "Believe What You Say" would become a classic, much less the most often recorded song of Rick's career.
You know, isn't it funny? I think when you're writing them, you certainly don't think like that. No, nobody thought of, you didn't think in terms of that. We had two small children. Dorsey and Albert had three at the time. And it's like, a lot of it you're working to feed your face. You're making a living. And you starve a lot. So it was just hard times. You sit down and you can write.
Here, then, is a composite of the recording spanning 27 years of "Believe What You Say."
I believe what you say when you say you're going steady with nobody else but me. I believe what you say when you say you don't kiss nobody else but me. I believe, I do believe, I believe, yeah, believe pretty big. Believe you're going steady with nobody else but me. Just can't rock no more. I believe, 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 I believe
baby, let me roll a line. Get a funny feeling that I'm never fine. She's been all up and down my spine. Tell everybody that you're mine, on mine. I believe, you believe, I believe, I believe, I believe pretty bad. Believe you're gonna steady with nobody else but me. Oh yeah, well I believe.
Even though the concept of the album was to do Rick's greatest hits, he was never one to be satisfied with living in the past, so he threw in one new track. It would become the last released recording of his lifetime.
I've got a girl, she's a regular date. When she's good, she's good. And when she's bad, she's great. Do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
You know what I mean?
I see what you mean.
If you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean. She looks cool in a sweater and a corduroy. She likes men, but she loves big boys. Do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Do you know what I mean?
I see what you mean.
If you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean. She likes to be around me. She knows where I stand. I'm so glad you found me. She finds me every time she can, yeah. Every evening when we do our thing, she stays home. Likes it here, but do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
But do you know what I mean?
I see what you mean.
If you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean. Time she came, yeah. Every evening when we do our thing, she stays home, cause she likes it here. Do you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Do you know what I mean?
I see what you mean.
If you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean. If you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean. Well, if you had a girl like mine, you know what I mean.
Having come full circle, it was a good time to review the 29-year musical career of Rick Nelson.
I'm walking, yes indeed, I'm talking for you and me, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. I'm lonely as I can be, and I've waited for your company, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. What you gonna do when the well runs dry? You're gonna run away and hide. I'm gonna run right by your side. For you, pretty baby, I'd even die. I'm walking, yes indeed, I'm talking for you and me, and I'm hoping that you come back to me. Hang on.
Habiba, baby. Habibop, baby, Habibop, baby. She's a gal for me. She got plenty of rhythm, got plenty of jive. And when we dance, I really come alive. My love for her so tender and sweet. My heart starts pounding every time we meet. Habibop, baby, still in her teens, just as sweet as she can be. Habibop, baby, in her old blue jeans, is Habibop, baby, for me. Habibop, baby, for me. I've been waiting in school all day long, waiting on the bell to ring so I could go home. I throw my books on the table, pick up the telephone. Hello, baby, let's get some going. Heading down to the drugstore to get a soda pop, throw a nickel in the jukebox, then we start to rock. The school cow, baby, gonna taste some news. You should look good in the baby doll shoe. Well, it's a one, two, a foot of a shoe. A three, four, get out on the floor. 5, 6, come get your kicks down the corner of Lincoln and a 46. Yeah!
If you love me like you say you, baby, be true to me. If you love me like you say you, baby, never stray from me. I I want you, darling, everybody beside, baby, now can't you see? Oh, baby, I'm sorry.
Oh, baby, I'm sorry.
For all the wrong I've done.
For all the wrong I've done.
Oh, baby, I'm sorry.
Oh, baby, I'm sorry.
For all the wrong I've done.
For all the wrong I've done.
Say you forgive me. I know I've done you mighty wrong.
I'd find you. the broken hearts stay. You can buy a dream or two to last you all through the years, and the only price you pay is a heart full of tears.
Well, all my friends are bopping the blues, it must be going round. All my friends are bopping the blues, and it must be going round. I love you, baby, but I must be rhythm bound. Well, the doctor told me, boy, you don't need no pill. Yeah, that doctor told me, son, you don't need no pills. Just a handful of niggles and jukebox to cure your ill.
I used to play around with hearts, hasten at my call. But when I met that little girl, I knew that I would fall for a little fool. Oh yeah, I was a fool. I'm a traveling man, made a lot of stops all over the world, and in every port I own the heart of at least one lovely girl. I've a pretty señorita waiting for me.
Guess my baby's got another date. Stood up, broken hearted again. I'll bet she's out having a ball, not even thinking of me at all. Stood up, broken hearted again. Well, I know just what I ought to do. I ought to find me somebody new. But baby, I couldn't forget about you. Stood up, broken hearted again.
Take a piece of chalk, draw a line around the world about 100 times, and that's how far I'd go for your sweet love. Count all the rain in a million years, make believe it's a million tears. Oh well, that's how much I'd cry for your sweet love. Sweet kisses I relive.
you don't love me anymore, and I can tell another boy has made you change. When I'm around, you're acting strange. You don't love me. String along. That's all I am, is just your string along. Someone that you just seem to bring along. Whenever you are all alone,
need some company,
you always turn to me.
String along,
that's all I do is sort of string along.
String along,
you never seem to notice I'm alone. I just want you to want me.
Hey there, little Miss T, you got me weak in the knee, wondering if you really care for me. Well, you don't say no, you don't say yes, you always make me guess. Please put my heart at ease, little Miss T. There's a cold, cold wind tonight, and I long to hold you tight. So come and warm my heart, I beg you, please. Hold me to lips up on a free little distance. The very thought of you, and I forget to do the little ordinary things that everyone ought to do. I'm living in daydream. I'm happy as a king, and foolish though it may seem, to me that's everything. The mere idea of you, the longing here for you, you'll never know how slow the moments go till I'm near to you. I see your face in every share, and I don't have one who cares. I don't have anything since I don't have you.
Sing me a song, you can't go wrong. to rhyme. Sing me a song, it won't take long. You ought to take the time. I came in wondering what it's all about. Now I know, 'cause I've been told I've got it figured out. Got everything she needs, she's an artist, she don't look bad. She's got everything she needs, she's an artist, she don't look bad. She can take the dark out of the nighttime, paint the daytime black. You may start outstanding, proud to steal her anything she sees. You can start outstanding, proud to steal her anything she sees. But you wind up peeking through a keyhole upon your knee. Garden party to reminisce with my old friends, a chance to share old memories and play our songs again. When I got to the garden party, they all knew my name, but no one recognized me. I didn't look the same, but it's all right now. Learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. People came from miles around. Go down to the sea, put your ears to the ground. To the waves and the sound that they made as they break along the shore. Never more to pass this way again.
Give in to to the charms of someone. Lay back in the arms of someone you love.
Return. New Year's Eve, 1985, as we continue remembering Ricky. As 1985 came to an end, Rick was splitting time between the road and the recording studio. He was working again with Jimmy Haskell on an album that, by all reports, would reestablish him as a great rocker. Anita Young recalls seeing Rick in that year.
The very last time we saw him was in July of 1985, and he was really excited about the album that he was working on. And he said he had, you know, finished recording it. And we talked about his children, and his eyes just lit up. He was so proud of his sons and his daughter Tracy, and he was tickled to death that they were following, you know, in the musical field.
At Christmas time, Rick was in California with the family. David spoke about that time and Rick's feelings.
He seemed a lot happier this last Christmas in 85 than I'd seen him in a long time, and it was almost like there was a lifting of weight off his shoulders that had been with him for about 4 or 5 years, and I think that things were starting to straighten out in his personal life, and he was hopefully writing more songs, had just recorded an album, which was a re-record of a lot of older records that he had done, and he was hopeful that would do well. Plus, he had television offers here in town, so he was very hopeful that his career was going to go up.
As the end of the year approached, Rick and the band, Bobby Neal, Ricky Enfeld, Patrick Woodward, and Andy Chapin, accompanied by road manager Clark Russell and Rick's fiance, Helen Blair, flew to Gunnersville, Alabama, to play at PJ's, a club owned by Pat Upton, who had sung with Rick on Playing to Win. Pat recalls Rick's final concert.
We had scheduled two shows Saturday night, and it went so well that we did another one Monday night. And, you know, it was a last-minute thing. He was really up. He was real, he was real positive about that. I think he felt real good about his music. He did two great shows. I mean, you know, because he always did. He always did. I heard, some of the new tunes he was doing. As a matter of fact, I worked those shows at my club with him. And we did one of them, and I thought it was on the next one.
The final song Rick played that night was an old Buddy Holly tune that he had recorded at ACPIC. His final words to his final audience were "Rave On for Me." On December 31st, 1985, Rick, Helen, Clark, and the band were asleep aboard their DC-3. They were en route to Dallas for a New Year's Eve concert. Somewhere near DeKalb, Texas, the pilot radioed the tower that smoke was filling the cockpit. He was instructed to make an emergency landing at a nearby airport, but that proved to be too far for them to make. He skillfully made the emergency landing in a pasture, but at that time, the passenger compartment had been engulfed by the fire, which was fed by the fuel from a space heater located at the back of the plane. At age 45, Rick Nelson was dead. The world had lost a great musical talent, and America had lost its favorite kid brother. Killed with him were fiancé Helen Blair, 29, road manager Clark Russell, 35, lead guitarist Bobby Neal, 38, drummer Ricky Inveld, 22, pianist Andy Chapin, 30, and bassist Patrick Woodward, 35. It seemed incomprehensible that this man who was so much a part of our society, who remained so vital, was gone. Gordon Stoker shares with us a note that Rick's mother had written him after the tragedy.
Well, she told me in the last note that I got from her, she said, "I still haven't come to grips that Rick is not out on the road and won't come home." You know, I believe that, you know, he's out on the road traveling, and I still believe that he'll be home, you know, soon.
Initial reports contained a rumor about the use of freebasing materials being the cause of the fire. These rumors were quickly proven to be false, but nevertheless, a cloud of suspicion hung over the accident. Gordon Stoker comments on Rick and drugs.
The guy cannot look 26 years, 26 and be 46. He was never late to a rehearsal. His temperament was always the same. His looks was always the same. He always looked super. I never, ever saw him get irritable when people bugged him and pushed him and pulled at him for autographs. these things did not go with being on drugs, if you understand what I mean. We work with a lot of stars that are on drugs, and they're very temperamental. They're very hard to get along with. Their temperament is never the same. They're one way one day and another way the next day. You never knew what they were going to take, what you said to them. None of this ever existed with Rick Nelson, and that's the reason I highly resent anyone even putting out the stuff at all that he might have been on drugs.
Pat Upton offers invaluable insight into the cause of the crash.
I spoke to the co-pilot after the crash, after he was well, and he told me that what started the fire, and the fire was started from repeated use of the heater on the airplane. The heating system that was on it was bad, so they had put a new heater on the plane. Now, as they were going, the warning light from the heater came on, and they cut the heater off, and somebody complained, and the pilot kept turning it on and off, and that is what started the plane crash, and freebasing is not what did it.
Apart from the rumors, the numbing truth remained. Rick Nelson was gone. We would never again have the chance to hear him sing, see his crooked smile, witness the shy gentleness of this one good man. We were, as a society, suddenly seized with the nagging doubt that perhaps we should have paid more attention while he was here. Now, over a year later, we have had time to distance ourselves from the pain of that last terrible day of 1985 and to evaluate the life of the man and the musician.
Try to remember.
I asked our guests how they would like the world to remember Rick Nelson. Omar Farag.
Oh, as a sincere human being, which he really was, he was a very warm guy. When you got to meet Rick and talk with Rick, he was very warm and very sincere. He's not like a lot of people in the music business that had the plastic personality. Rick was very warm, very sincere.
Tom DeMichael.
Rick Nelson should be remembered as a musician, as opposed to a performer, as an artist, as opposed to an interpreter. I think his contributions will be regarded as very fine pieces of pop music that can appeal to an awful lot of people.
Rita Birchka.
He was a very gentle, loving person with a heart of gold who touched a lot of hearts.
Ronnie Mack.
I think after all of my years of trying to make people aware of how significant, how good he was, I would probably, for once and for all, like him to be remembered as a very important and significant person in the history of rock and roll. I think I would like him to be remembered in a class with guys like Elvis and Carl Perkins and Jerry Lee Lewis and Fats Domino and the Everly Brothers and Buddy Holly and Gene Vincent and Eddie Cochran, because all of those people themselves would consider Rick one of them.
Diana Kotchick.
I would like people to remember him that he was a star in his own right. He did a lot of things that he didn't get credit for. And I think now is the time that we can do that. It's too bad he's not here to hear this. And it's a little too late for it, but better late than never.
Judy Markey.
As I said, as really a first-string musician, or a first-string rock and roll guy, you know, as someone who's, I guess, worth being memorable, as someone who was extremely diligent, I think he was that, because he traveled around even when, you know, times were tough, and kind of vulnerable, and, you know, maybe a little uncomplicated in a world that idolizes complex things and looks for mystery. I don't know that there was too much mystery about him, and I think that was part of his charm.
Anita Young.
I would like him to be remembered as being a very talented musician and also being a very good individual, as far as he was very modest. And his personality, I think, was the kind of, I would like to see, like, my son grow into to have that type of personality, to be easygoing, to be very happy with, being able to do the type of thing that he enjoyed doing. I think that people should remember that he loved performing for small groups live, and I think it was rare that to be able to spend your life doing what you enjoyed doing.
Pat Upton.
Paul's just a good human being, a sincere entertainer, a conscientious entertainer. He was just a good person.
Thurley Burnett.
The way I remember him, warmth and kindness, tenderness. He was just a wonderful, gentle kind of a person.
Ellen Bush.
He's an honest, caring person. More than anything, he tried to put across in his music what he felt as a person. I don't think he said anything in his lyrics that he didn't really feel. He wasn't a double standard person. So I personally feel, to me, his biggest contribution was his honesty and sincerity.
Randy Meisner.
I know that he loved his kids very much. So I think, he remembered as a good father and a great musician and a very humble, sincere person.
Gordon Stoker.
I'd like for people to remember Rick Nelson as one of the kindest, most considerate, a person that never, ever got tired of people asking for his autograph. He never tired at all of people asking to take pictures. He was never temperamental. He was just one of the kindest, sweetest natured people that I've ever worked with. And that not only was in the studio, but that was on the road, what have you. I've seen the boy stand for an hour after performance, wringing wet with sweat. And he always had a smile. Rick Nelson never, ever showed one moment that he didn't like the fact that the fans liked him and loved him. And I would like for people to remember him that way. He's one of the kindest, sweetest people. And if you ever would have known Rick Nelson, you would have loved him dearly.
John Fogerty.
Basically, starting with his induction into the Hall of Fame, it's like I would like him to have the credit that's been long overdue. He was really one of the pioneers of rock and roll. I mean, he's an essential pioneer in the same sense that Little Richard and Fats Domino and Elvis and Chuck are pioneers. He was there right at the beginning. I mean, amazingly, those records, the early ones, are out in 1956. And if you think of, Elvis made his breakthrough that same year, that puts Ricky Nelson right there. I was in the sixth grade. I would like the world to remember him as a classy guy that made wonderful, wonderful rock and roll records and certainly contributed immensely to the fabric of early rock and roll.
Carl Perkins.
I'd like for the world, young and old, to think about that young fella who had the chance to and had the qualifications to have been a super actor. But he walked away from a profession that so many, many people in the world would run and stand in line for the rest of their life to get to be on the big screen. But see, Rick wanted to play his music, and he played it. And I think I'm speaking for millions around the world. And it was just such a shame to have lost him at such an early age when I think he had many, many more great records in him.
James Burton.
Well, I would like the world to remember Ricky Nelson as being one of the nicest persons on earth, and not only a great entertainer and a great singer and a great actor. I would like to say that he was just one of the greatest people that I'd ever worked with, and I'd like to see people, I would like for people to remember him as that kind of person.
Jimmy Haskell.
As the wonderful guy that he was. As the great performer and wonderful guy that he was. I don't know, it's hard to put it into words. I'm feeling a little sad.
David Nelson.
I think he would like people to remember him as a singer who loved to perform and loved to please audiences and that was his role in life, and he got more reward out of an audience thoroughly enjoying his performance than anything. And I would like to think of him as a singer and as probably one of the best human beings that I've ever met.
Even December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow.
Perhaps the way Rick would like to be remembered himself was expressed in a song from Rudy V, which he wrote. According to him, he should be remembered simply as the Gypsy Pilot. I only met Rick Nelson once, It was a cold November evening several years ago outside of a club in the suburbs of Chicago. As he came out of the stage door, I walked up to him and shook his hand and thanked him for the influence that he had on my life. Typically, he shyly thanked me. We talked for a few moments, the wind and snow swirling around us. Then, without him ever saying he had to go, without him ever looking back at the warm car waiting for him, we ended our conversation and walked away from each other. I had done it. I had met Rick Nelson. Moments later, I realized that I hadn't gotten his autograph. But then I thought, well, I'll see him again. Perhaps someday I will. But for now, I, like the millions of fans and friends around the world, will have to take my comfort in the musical legacy that he has left us. And in those times when missing him becomes a bit too acute, we can take out a few of the old albums, put them on the turntable, and spend a few more hours remembering Ricky. I'm John Powers.
Personally, what are you going to miss about Rick the most?
His smile, the fact that he always wanted to greet you, and just like when I got sick 2 years ago, he sent me a plant. You know, not many, you know, people, stars we work with do it, and the plant's still sitting in my hall. I'm looking at it right now, and that plant is still blooming, which is what I like to remember Rick. When I look at it, I like to remember him as still blooming, as a flower, because Rick Nelson's memory will always be here.
Life go on without me. Take it and you'll see. It doesn't matter. Life, I know what your game is. You take it and trade it for another. Before you're over, I want something to show for all my troubles. Time, come on in. I see you back again. Where you going now? I thought you know somehow. If you keep going, I'll try to throw in a little love. Life, I can't do without you. There's something about you that keeps me going. Don't wanna stop now. I've been through so much now because of you. Tell me, life, what are you here for? Tell me, life, I wanna know more. Tell me, life, what are we here for?